There in the second period, it finally happened, an historic night at the Auditorium. It's been a long time coming, and tonight it finally happened. Gil Perreault becoming the 12th player in NHL history to reach the 500-goal mark. It happened in the second period against New Jersey. Ted Darling calls the historic goal.
Back to the point. Knight is there to keep it in. Foligno's got Perreault in front. He shoots. He scores! He's got it! Gil Perreault! Goal number 500!
Well, you know, it's a good feeling at home because, you know, after playing 16 years with the Sabres, I want to score that goal at home. It's a big thrill, you know, and I'm sure the fans really, really like it.
Goes wide of the net.
But the Devils wanted no part of history. Third period, Sabres up 3-2, but watch Greg Adams in front all alone, beating Tom Barrasso, that tying things at 3. But can't spoil this night, just over 4 minutes to play. Paul Sear, perfect feed to Doug Smith. Smith buries it. Sabres win it 4-3. Move back ahead of Boston into third place in the Adams division. But the night belongs to Gilbert Perreault, goal number 500. And he'll be with us live coming up on Sports Extra. Elsewhere in the NHL, it was Chicago over St. Louis 4-2. The Flyers over the Rangers 4-1. Washington beating the Islanders again this time. Well, Gil Perreault gets number 500 in front of the home folks. Perreault will be with us live right here on Sports Extra. Also coming up, a victory by the Sabres over the Devils helps him celebrate. A pressure win for his country by Jimmy Arias. The Griffs get shut out in postseason bids. It's all coming up next on Sports Extra.
Extra. Buffalo's only half-hour sports wrap-up. With TV2 sports director Ed Kilgore and Wes Goforth.
Almost a capacity crowd at the Odd tonight, and although the score was Buffalo 4, the New Jersey Devils 3, that's not what the folks are going to be talking about who saw this game tonight. They saw Gilbert Perreault score his 500th career goal, and it was a beauty. Came in the second period and actually had a big part to do in the win.
It was a beauty. You know, of course, Bert, that's what he's known as. He got the assist from Mike Foligno, his old buddy, and I don't think they could have ordered a more perfect script, either one of them. And, of course, the 2 points for the Sabres puts them in third place, Ed, so it's a happy night for right now. Anyway.
Well, that is for sure, and as we mentioned, Mr. Perreault is going to be here with us live coming up in just a little bit. First, we're going to show you the highlights. Now, October 10th, 1970, I'm sure you can remember this, Mr. Perreault. First NHL goal, the season opener in Pittsburgh, a 2-1 game. The Sabres win this one. And then 16 years later, Perreault became the 12th player in NHL history to hit 500. Let's listen to Ted call it.
Kicking it, trying to get in to get the shot. He did. Chevrier made the save on Perreault. Now the puck comes back to the point. Knight is there to keep it in. Foligno's got Perreault in front. He shoots. He scores. He's got it. Gilbert Perreault, goal number 500. Goal 500 for Perreault. Only 11 other players have recorded 500 or more in almost 70 seasons of NHL hockey. Perreault becomes the 12th player to join the 500 club as he adds another page to the Sabres history book. 16 seasons, over 1,200 games, and now 500 goals for Gilbert Perreault.
And a pretty select club that Gilbert has moved in with. Gordie Howe, the leader, Esposito, Dion Hull, Busick, Richard, Makita, Mihailovic, Bossy Lafleur, Béliveau, and Gilbert is certainly within reach of the guy he grew up loving to watch play, and Perreault now at 500 goals. First period, Sabres take a 1-0 lead as Gilles Hamel with a shorthand goal. That's Hamel's third shorthand goal of the season. Sabres take a 1-0 lead. Then in the second period, two on one, and Kirk Muller beats Barrasso to the short side. It's 1-1. And then came the goal by Perreault, and sure, it's worth another look. We'll take another look at the angle here, and Foligno with some good work behind the boards gets it out to Perreault right in front. 2-1 at that point. He had a 3-minute standing ovation. Then New Jersey would come back. They were apparently not impressed with the historic goal. Uli Heimer ties it. And then you see the press box there. The Sabres wounded. Ruff, Tucker, Verta, Lever, far too crowded up there. Third period, Foligno gets his 35th. And that gives the Sabres a 3-2 lead. It was short-lived, though, because Greg Adams would come back, and he wound up unmolested in front of Barrasso. It's 3-3. And then a very alert play by Sear and Smith. As Sear sets up Doug, it's 4-3 at the 15:29 mark, and the Sabres win it 4-3. Wes was at the odd and talked to the Sabres.
Well, all I heard was Gilbert yelling in front of the net, and all I kept thinking was just try to get him the puck as fast as possible. And when I came around the net, I just wheeled it out in front. I didn't realize he was all by himself as much as he was, and he put it right where he wanted it, put it home, and he scored us what I wanted. What a big thrill.
Probably the best scoring chance he's had in a long time.
Yeah, you know, he's been around the net. He's had some chances further out, but not many right from there, and he made no mistake about it. He put it right, put it home.
There's a little bit of pressure off now.
Lots of pressure. I think for Gilbert, this was on his mind, and as one of his teammates, and I think speaking for the team, we're very relieved that he got it, and yet very happy and very proud of Gilbert for getting it.
Good way to take off on a road trip. Tuesday night, Sabres in St. Louis. You'll see that game here on TV2. Wednesday in Chicago, and then Saturday in Los Angeles. That game also right here on TV2 at 10:30. So the Adams standings now looks a little bit better for the Sabres because they have moved up into third place. And as we take a look here at the standings, Sabres with 70 points. They are ahead of the Bruins, although Boston does have a game in hand. Hartford is still hanging in there, 6 points back, also with a game in hand.
Okay, and the Sabres' next two opponents met head-on tonight. The St. Louis Blues are making a run at the Blackhawks for first place over in the Norris Division. In the first period tonight, Steve Larmer picks up the first of two goals for him on the night on a rebound of a Doug Wilson shot from the point here in Chicago. It was out to a 1-0 lead. Now this is later, same period, same guy. Larmer, nice feed to Al Secord right here. Secord scoring his 37th of the year. It's 2-0 Hawks, but Steve Larmer is not done yet. We go to the second period, a 2-on-1 with Secord. Steve Larmer tries to pass, but it's blocked by Charlie Bergeois. The puck comes back to Larmer. He put it in anyway. It was 3-0 Chicago at that point. And right now, late in the hockey game, the Blackhawks lead the Blues 4-2. 4-2 late in the third period. And there is a race for the top spot in the Patrick Division. Islanders at Washington today. Bobby Carpenter scoring from Alan Haworth. 1-0 Caps in the first period. Second period, Brent Sutter for the Islanders picking up a loose puck. Over to brother Dwayne. He would beat Pete Peters. We're tied now at 1-1. Now, later second period, Dave Christian to Craig Laughlin. Laughlin off Kelly Rudy's skate, and the Caps have a 2-1 lead. Later, Bobby Gould going to feed Larry Murphy coming up, the offensive-minded defenseman for Washington. Slap shot tipped in by Gould. Gould gets the goal. The Caps win it by a count of 3-1. Washington over the Islanders 3-1. They still stay a point behind Philadelphia, though. The Flyers beat the Rangers 4-1. Winnipeg over Pittsburgh 5-3. Detroit and Calgary tied at 3-3 in overtime, of course. Chicago, again late in the third, led St. Louis 4-2 at Chicago Stadium. And out west tonight, Edmonton has beaten Los Angeles 7-3.
And I know this will break your hearts. Quebec center Dale Hunter has some problems. He's the target of numerous trade rumors in Quebec, and on top of that, he's got a date with NHL officials in New York tomorrow to discuss his latest high-sticking incident against the Sabres. Hunter gets the chance to defend his stick work against Billy Height 8 days ago in Quebec. The high stick broke Height's nose, and Hunter was assessed a 5-minute major. In a similar incident last year, Hunter received a 3-game suspension after knocking out Mike Ramsey's front teeth with a high stick, and he could get more of the same, and in my opinion, certainly deserves it. Our Sports Extra question tonight, who do you think is going to win the NCAA basketball tournament? And the number 644-9815. Who do you think is going to win the NCAA basketball tournament? And coming up, Gil Perreault right here, so don't go away. We'll be right back. Gilbert Perreault would go away from Buffalo, especially to Montreal or Quebec. They would ask him one question. They'd say, hey, Mr. Perreault, when are you going to score that 500th goal? You don't have to answer that question anymore, do you, Gilbert? I know you were beginning to wonder, weren't you?
Well, you know, tonight was the night, but, you know, you start to think about it. We only had 13 games left, and, you know, you start to think about it. I hope it's tonight or the next game, so.
All right. Just nice work by Foligno.
Oh, yeah. Mike and Bill Hyde. Bill kept the puck in, and Mike just did the great work behind the net. Was easy. Easy goal. Just put it in.
Nice to do it at home, huh?
Oh, yeah, it was great. You know, good feeling, you know, in front of your own fans, and it was a great thrill, you know.
Now, I know you didn't want the guys to lift you up like that, did you?
It's Mike. Mike fooling you again and just want to carry me there. I thought I was going to get hurt there.
Yeah, pull groin or something, yeah.
Gilbert, your teammates were so concerned. They wanted you to get it, you know, just as badly as you did. And they're trying to get you the puck, and yet on the other hand, they can't really look for you to set you up. And that made things doubly hard, didn't it?
Oh, yes. You know, I had a lot of good chances the last few games against Washington. I think I had a really good chance, three good chances in front of the net, but the goalie made a good save or the defenseman stopped it. So it was... And, you know, you put more pressure on yourself. You know, every time you miss a good chance like that, you say, oh, you know, you missed that one and it should have been in. But like I say, you know, like I had about 20 games to score two goals, and you think about it and you want to score more goals. You don't want to score only two goals. You want to score at least 10 goals or 12 goals in 20 games. But it doesn't happen like that.
Gilbert, even after scoring now 500 goals, even a veteran can get into a situation where sometimes he wonders, what do I have to do to get the puck in the net? You were struggling a little bit, and I know this will be a confidence builder for you, and as far as the team is concerned, you're still a guy they don't count on as much as they did in the past, but still, you know that as the captain, you're a guy that has to score some goals coming down the stretch here.
Oh yes, you know, like I'm here with the Sabres to score goals and to play with the experience that I got, you know, to make good plays and to help my teammate. But this year I had a little bit of problem, you know, like I had a good start for about 25 games and hurt my foot, and I came back and hurt my foot like three times, so I just couldn't get going after that. But you know, I don't want to use that as an excuse. I just have to play better hockey. I'm not playing good hockey, and it's my fault. It's not the team's fault. It's my own problem, and I have to get in better shape and work harder at it.
Also, I know Carmen had a rough time bringing the little guy in, and that also had to be weighing in the back of your mind, and it seems like you've been a little freer since that happened.
Well, you know, it's a great relief for sure. You know, like we had a problem with that. My wife, she was in the bed for 4 months, and we lost the last baby we had 3 years ago. So, you know, all this, it was a build-up inside me and my wife too. And but I don't want to use that as an excuse to play hockey. And when you go on the ice, you don't think about those things. You just want to help the team, and you want to work hard at it. And I haven't done that this year. I was... playing good, I think, for the first 25 games, and after that, just couldn't do anything.
Well, I know after the first 25 games, when people would ask you about retirement, you would seem to lean a little bit and say, you know, at that point, it's a little bit harder to keep in perspective. Now, you probably feel a little younger right now, don't you?
Well, you know, like, the heart say yes, but sometimes the legs say no, so.
Yeah.
It's, no, I'm 35 years old. I have to look at it, you know, and it doesn't come as easy as it used to. And the young players, they got to take charge, you know. They have to score a lot of goals, and I'm there to help them too. And like I say, you know, like it doesn't get easier; it gets tougher for me.
How much of a disappointment would it be if you had to close out your career without winning the Stanley Cup? Is that something you've just about? You always hope, obviously, but reality is that the Sabres right now would have to be considered a bit of a long shot. It could always happen, you never know, but will that be a big disappointment?
Oh, yes, it will be, but, you know, in hockey, you never have to count yourself out, you know. It's like you say, you know, it's a long shot maybe this year, but you never know, you know. Sometimes it takes just a few games to get... a lot of confidence in each other and go in the playoff and play good hockey. I remember a few years ago, like, we had a little bit of problem and we went in Montreal and we beat them in three games. So you couldn't do nothing against us. And that's the way it is in hockey. If we can get everything together and play good hockey, we'll be tough.
I think so. I think we have just a few seconds left here. I want to give you a little something just so you'll remember us here, Gilbert. We have this nice jacket. We had a special tailor make it up for you. It says WGRZ TV2 Sports on, and then on the back, it says Sports Extra down, wait a minute, where, can we see it right here? Yeah, Now, see, that's, now you could cover that up if you wanted when you wear it, but we would prefer that you, but anyway, take that with you.
Thank you very much.
And we're right on the playoffs. And
yeah.
Of course, the finals.
Thank you very much.
But anyway, and you have the puck, right? Somebody saved it for you?
Oh, yes, I got the puck. So. It's a good good thrill, and I'm very happy to score it at home. So.
Great. Well, I think the 16,000 fans and then the fact there will be 50,000 who say they were there. But thanks, Gilbert. And,
thank you.
Gilbert Perreault with us, and we're going to be back with more of our show here on Sports Act.
Put the puck in, and it went in, you know, and I said, that's it, there he goes, 500, you know, and it's a good feeling.
I teased him. I said, "Jesus, Bert, I'm glad you got it before I retired."
Torino's got Perreault in front. He shoots. He scores. He's got it. Gilbert Perreault, goal number 500. Goal 500.
No question, Bert's a smooth operator. The Sabres left town this afternoon on a four-game swing. It'll take.